Hello everyone, this is Randy here again, another episode of Farming Simulator 2013. And we are playing on Springhill Valley. This is the 1,000 subscriber special. We're going to do maybe, I'm thinking maybe like 5 videos or so on this map. Just kind of have some fun. Sounds like something's running over here. Anyway, like I said, we're going to do like 5 or so episodes, maybe a couple more, I don't know, we'll see once. Maybe a couple less, depends how it goes. Just kind of play around a little bit on this map. It's a really cool map, I think. Really, not really a small map, but really tight areas to get around. So, definitely going to make it a little bit of a challenge. Maybe a lot of a challenge, actually, might be more appropriate. Yeah, this is released on FSUK, I think maybe a month or so ago now. Happened to see this map and kind of, you know, checked it out. It's like, do a little play on it. So anyway, figure we'll do like a 1,000 subscriber special, like I said, a couple episodes. So, go through the equipment here a minute. We got our 4 disc. I'm not sure how well this one's going to work, if I'm going to be able to get this down through this map or not. Also, I've got this windrower / swather. Kind of tried that on the Iowa map. Unfortunately, I kind of crashed with course play, so didn't actually get the chance to use it. Okay, this would be a perfect map to give this a try on. And then we got our Massey Ferguson 1250. Now, it seems like everybody who plays on this map on YouTube, anyway, has this tractor, so I figured that must be the thing to do, so I bought this tractor. I really don't know why. I really don't have any intentions of using it. I just happened to look up on YouTube. It's like, Springhill Valley. It's like, wow. And there's a lot of people doing Let's Plays on this map, by the way, so that's why I won't really be doing more than a couple episodes. And that is, by the way, why I bought that tractor. It's like, I happen to see that's like, just about everybody has this tractor. So, really nice tractor, by the way. I mean, that's nothing wrong with it. I love this tractor. It's really nice. For a massive failure, that is. Yeah, I got some other equipment over here. Got one of my favorite tractors. Not the greatest detail. I think it's actually from Giants, this John Deere. I particularly like this tractor. I don't know why, but I do like it. Don't use it a whole lot. At least I haven't recently. Also got another one of my favorite tractors, this Farmall. Seems a little undersized to sit next to the John Deere here for some reason. And then we got, don't recall what this is. Oh, that scary guy up there. It is a mixing wagon. Like I said, I don't remember, I guess it really doesn't say what it is. It's a mixing wagon. Self-propelled. Never used it. Got a little bit bigger tractor over here, Case International 5130. Not sure if I'll use that tractor or not. It's a little big for the map. Probably. Probably going to try to stick with these smaller tractors. Got the little Ursus, I don't know if this is really a steam. I don't think this is a steam one. More of just an older tractor. Fertilizer spreader. Got a Bobcat T180. This is the one with tracks. I believe EuroDZN released that one a couple weeks ago, something like that. Got the tires there for the Massey. Got our Lindener. Maybe that'd be kind of a nice little vehicle on this map. And let's see, I think that's about it. Over here, oh, I do have a truck for unloading. Not sure how big it is. I've actually never really used that one, so I thought about just getting the Ural truck again, but like I said, I already had that one. Got a John Deere over here with our Vaderstad Cedar. It is the John Deere 7810, so this is probably another big tractor. You know, I was able to get it down through the lanes, so I think we're okay at the moment. And then finally over here, let's see, on the field, I got a John Deere Combine 4420. I think that's supposed to say hydrostatic there, I think. So yeah, it's actually got tracks on it. I think it's a pretty cool looking combine, in my opinion. It's, whoa, the view is crazy. I notice the views on this map sometimes go a little crazy because of all the objects and stuff that's trying to move around and get through. Not the greatest looking combine. Oh, the views are reversed. How nice. I'll have to try to remember to fix that. Hate it when they do that. And then over here I do have the head for it. Now I actually do not have the head for this combine. I could not find a head for this combine either, so I don't know. I'll have to go actually probably look at the mod, see if it's in there. Maybe it's getting overwritten. I have no idea. But I actually grabbed the head off the John Deere. I think it's a 650. I think this is what this head was off of. It seemed to fit the best. It's like the only head I could find that was small enough that it actually fit. You seem to be locked on there. Don't think there's any lock function on that head. Yeah, there we go. Disconnect it. So yeah, we'll start out with some harvesting here. I ran into the back of the tree already. Oh well. Yeah, I tried a bunch of different heads on this. The trouble with it, they all went too low. They mounted too high on the combine there and would drag on the ground. So this is like the only one head view is too fast, huh? Okay. Try that again at speed one. I'm going to have to fix this view. That is speed one, isn't it? Okay, let me try that again. Yeah, that was speed one. That's too fast. Interesting. Maybe I should have tested this combine a little more. Can I do speed four, maybe? Wow, speed fours are like really fast on this combine. Yeah, it's interesting. Well, this is off to a great start. Actually, can I hire a worker? Will he be okay? Actually, he probably will not be okay. I can see what's going to happen right now. It's going to crash into that tree, I bet. Yeah, okay. I kind of seen that happen. Happening. Ooh. Yeah, I've never used this combine before. I don't even recall where it came from. I know I got it because I seen it had the tracks on it. They look pretty cool. I mean, they actually did a really good job of modeling these. It's always, you know, one concern with the tracks. They sometimes do a very crappy job of that. Anyway, we do have a little bit of a solution here. This is field number. I believe we're on that one there, so that would be field 17 with barley. Set them up in field work mode. I believe that's the right one. This is fertilizing seeding. This is, yeah, field work. So number 17. Oh, that was too far. Interestingly enough, it'll actually only show the fields you own here. 7 meter. Really? That is 7 meters? I thought that was a 6 meter head. I'm going to drop that down just a little bit. Starting corner, sure. North, sure. Yep, whatever. Let's do four of them. Let's do the first waypoint, please. And your speed, 14 mile an hour. Let's try something a little slower there, maybe 6. Might have to see if I'm able to make that turn. Yeah, let's fix them up here so I can make that turn. There you go. Ah, you should be good, hopefully. And I'll have to see off-screen if I can try to fix that or just put the ES limiter in so I can actually control the speed of this combine. There we go. And while we do that, we can read some comments, hopefully. As soon as I can pull them up, anyway. Oh, let's see what's here. I'm just going to read the ones from Professional Farmer and Farming Sim here, seeing it's going to be a little while before I, well, not really long, a couple days before I get back to it, so. Michael was saying on my last Professional Farmer video, the weather never changes till 7 a.m., so you do have to wait till 7 before it changes. I didn't realize it took me that long to upload a video. And yeah, normally it doesn't. It takes about 4 to 6 hours. That's pretty standard for me to upload a video anyway. My internet connection is, I got a 10 megs down and a 1 meg up connection. Best I can get for my area, so that happens when you live out in the country. Alex was saying that he agrees with Michael. I should probably actually read the rest of Michael's comment then, since what he says. Michael says I'm the farming king on YouTube, so okay, thank you for that. I don't know if I'm that good. I'm not sure about that one. Alex says he agrees with Michael. One of the best farming sim YouTubers, so thank you for that again. The Crafter's Mine. I should get to Virgin Media. They got 150 megs down and 10 megs up. Oh, I'm turning green right now. That sounds good. Let's see. Find the next episode here. Actually, I think I need to go back 1 minute. No, this is the right one, I think. And I did not read the comments from last Farming Sim episode on the last Farming Sim video. Most of them had to do with the my question about what I should do for the 1,000 subscriber special. Quite varied in your response. I think I actually got a response to like everyone I asked. So I think I mentioned a couple different options. I got a comment for everyone, I think. So Craft Farms said I should do a live stream. Yeah, I commented back to him. Due to my internet connection, I can't do that. So kind of a bummer. That would make a really good one, I think. Jacob was saying I should do something like farming with R.D. Allen. I'm assuming you're referencing my video there I put up. Tim said multiplayer. Will said multiplayer. Yeah, I know a couple of you guys said multiplayer. Again, due to my internet connection, I'm kind of limited on that. Speed-wise, I can do multiplayer. It's just the fact that my connection cuts in and out so much that causes the problem. So yeah, it'd be really hard for me to do multiplayer. I'd be, you know, cutting in and out every couple of minutes. That's no fun, in my opinion, anyway. Matt was saying I should use the bunker instead of the bales. That'd be for the silage, I believe he's referencing. Blake Arthur says I should do Springhill, so that is indeed what we're doing. Yeah, we're kind of doing farming sim because I kind of got from the comments, it's like most of you kind of said farming sim related items, so that's the reason we're doing farming sim. Craft Farms again said I should just pick a large map and lots of money. So this is not exactly a large map, but I did pick a map. I don't really know of any really good large maps off the top of my head, so this is the one map I kind of wanted to play on a little bit, so kind of went with this one. Cole said I should do the car mechanic simulator. Matt said I could do both. I could do both. I thought about that. We'll see once how this goes. I might still do that. But Matt says, this is the same Matt. He said I should do multiplayer. Dylan was saying for the next map I should do Idaho. We'll see what's about that. I know Ian Robinson is doing Idaho, I believe it is. So I don't know if you guys want to see another Idaho map already or not. Not another Idaho map. Another YouTuber doing the Idaho map, I probably should say. Dylan was also saying I could play some Call of Duty. I don't play any Call of Duty. I do play Battlefield 4 and 3 and all the other ones before it. Ben was saying a spin tires playthrough. I am still kind of planning on doing that one yet. I look for that probably sometime in the future. We'll probably just do like one map and we'll do a playthrough of that. Again, should only take like a week or something. So Zycoon Plays. He was asking how to create a course play course for mowing the grass. I did think I mentioned his comment in the last episode, and we did look at that a little bit. And that'd be episode 25. I kind of went through quickly how to create a course for that. Okay, I think that's all the comments, and then we do have the comments from last one as well. It looks like four times around this field will about be done. Yes, it will, in fact. Oh, no, not quite. There'll be like a little piece in the middle here. Okay, now the question is, which way is he going to go here? You watch, he'll go the short way. It is the short way, too. Oh, man. I probably should have looked at that. Oh, well. Wow, this thing must have a huge tank on that. I just noticed that, folks. 8,800, and look how much it's, only, what was it, 30%? Yeah, not even 30%. Oh, my goodness. That's a mite crazy. Okay, then we're for episode 25 for the comments. Oh, Matt was saying I forgot to do the comments. Yeah, that's because I'm doing them now. I didn't think they really fit with the last episode, so that's kind of why I left them off. They had more to do with this video, I thought, so that's why we're doing them now. And he says I should sell the John Deere and go with the red theme. Which, yeah, that's kind of what we're doing, so it probably would fit better. Kind of doing a red theme on that map with the Massey Ferguson's and the Case tractors. We do have the one blue one, obviously. And we do have another John Deere tractor. Farm Boy was saying I should get the Massey 7626. Yeah, it's a really nice tractor. Yes, it does look like a really nice tractor, and I do hope to get it as soon as we can. The Crafter's Mind says, good job with the videos. Keep it going. Plan 2. Oh, and he says, oh, do Minecraft. Oh, you know what? I think that's the only one I did not see is do Minecraft. So now someone did finally say Minecraft. A little late now. Although I do look forward to that, and there might be a video coming forward on that in a little bit. I am building a rather large nuclear reactor, and I might just do like a little video on that. Guys might like to see that, especially if it explodes or something. I mean, obviously I'm trying to make it so it don't, so it might not be too exciting, but if it does explode, I'll try to get that recorded. Then he was also asking the Crafter's Bind, do I use Windows or Macintosh? Macintosh is crap, so I use Windows. Just kidding. Yes, I do use Windows. Though I do have some Apple devices as well, namely phone and tablet. But my computer itself is actually a Windows computer. Pretty much if you play games, you pretty much have to have a Windows computer. It's not don't have to, but most games only work on Windows, and if they do work on Mac, they're usually not as good, or there's problems with them, so, and yeah, just not as good a selection. So yeah, Windows definitely favors the gaming market. Anyway, let's grab our truck over here, I guess. I think this is a Zill truck, something like that. Definitely an older looking one. So yeah, I kind of tried to go with a little bit older theme on this map. Unfortunately, I don't have a whole lot of old mods. I tried to kind of pull out the ones I do have. Yeah, I don't know why, but it seems like the vehicles go really slow through here. At least certain ones do anyway. Out around by the farm area, it's, I don't know if there's like a speed limit going or what. Probably once we get off here, I think we'll probably go faster. Yeah, I see once we get off that road there, we just pick it right up. Now, will you be nice and open the pipe for me? Oh, you will. Excellent. I think I'm going to need a bigger truck. Well, that's not too bad. Let's see, and that dump point is around here somewhere. Again, I gotta find that back. So yeah, for anybody looking for a really highly detailed, challenging map to play on, this is definitely it. Let's see what's here. That is... there's that dump point again. I think that's over here somewhere. Says it's right here. Interesting. Ah, boy. Been a while since I've been on this map here. I kind of just did a little look through. Played just a couple minutes here. That was back, oh, a little bit after it came out. So, remembering where everything is again. And I have been watching Ian Robinson's Let's Play on this as well. I think he's actually ending his from the sounds of it. Just too many people doing it on YouTube. So, adding myself to one of the ones doing it as well. But like I said, only going to do a couple episodes. Just kind of a little special. Yeah, there's a couple vehicles that go like really slow through here. So I'm thinking they got something built into the map. Don't think this is the right spot. I thought there was another location around here somewhere. Yeah, there's one up by the other area there. Might be actually where I have to go. I think that's actually where you have to go on this one, now that I think about it. Not that we really need to actually... you know what, we can actually probably just take this and sell it. Brewery is, and this is barley, so at the brewery. Let's see, where is the brewery again? I thought it told me here where the items were. Apparently this is not one of the maps that does. Okay, that's fine, we can just drive around. Kind of take a look at this map. We maybe got another 10 minutes or so to go on this episode. Oh, it said he is done. Okay. I know the biogas plant's up by 31 and 29 there. Pretty sure the brewery there's on the town area, which I'm kind of going the wrong way for. But you know what? I think I can go up this way, though. We can cut across this field here. Hop on the road down here. Doesn't really matter where we sell this. I did give myself a fair whack of money, so no, we're not hurting for money. It's all cheated in money, by the way. So yeah, if we ever want money for anything, yeah, no. Back on the road here again. It's going stinking slow. I don't know why, but. I know this truck, and don't remember what the other vehicle was, did that as well, so... seems like the speed limit's 9 mile an hour. I think, is this the brewery here? This might be the brewery here. As long as it accepts barley, I really don't care. Yeah, it's a pretty nice looking truck, I'll have to say. Could use to hold a little more, that make it a little more useful, but anyway, let's let the combine sit for now. We'll stop him. And I think I'll show you guys one more piece of equipment I don't think I've showed yet. We got over here a New Holland speed rower. I don't know how well the speed part will work, but we'll find out. We're gonna mow some grass over here. That way we can use our grass tools. The windrower and the pickup units. Don't have any baler yet anyway. Let's see, turn it on. Looks like those are the only controls for lift harvester. Or lift the cutter, that is. Yeah, that doesn't look too bad. This is the speed roar off of Mod Hoster. I think there's one on American Eagle Modding too that has one. I'm not sure if this is the same one or not. Oh, that's interesting. Doesn't look like it's actually mowing all the grass, although it is leaving a windrow though. Another mod I actually haven't tested. I've heard, though, it's supposed to be pretty good, so that's why I actually didn't test it. It is version 2 of this, by the way, so I don't know what they fixed from version 1, but... And surprisingly, I can actually get this down through the roads on this map. At least I haven't been able to so far, anyway. I think the head on this is, you can clip through a little bit of it, so that's probably why. The head does detach as well, so you could probably actually put it up on a trailer if you wanted to or had to. Yeah, it's interesting, like, bits and pieces of this part of the field don't actually mow. Not sure if that's a... speed rower's fault or the grass on this map, but I like that warning up there. That I think that says a lot. I wish I could read that. It looks like it'd be pretty interesting reading on that warning label. I'd like to know what it actually says there, but... from the general idea of the picture, it doesn't look too good, though. Yeah, with that, folks, I think we'll call it an episode here. If there's anything you actually want to see on this map, let me know. We've got a couple episodes to do some things, so I haven't really set out anything I actually want to accomplish on this map. So, you know, seeing I'm only going to do a couple episodes, not a whole lot we can accomplish in that. But, you know, there's some things we can play around with and do, I figured. So, yeah, if folks have any comments or questions, be sure to leave them below. And as always, thanks for watching, and till next time.